Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
I have a Maker. He formed my heart before even time began. My life was in His hands. He knows my name.
God, you alone are God. There is none other but you. You who are the Alpha and Omega. Before the beginning, you are God. We come into your presence and we worship you. Our righteousness, our peace, our provider, our refuge, our fortress, and our salvation. We bow before your throne, you who sit in the highest heaven. Glory and honor and praise and majesty be unto you. Almighty God and most merciful Father, we give you thanks and praise for the many blessings you have blessed us with. We give you thanks today for life, and more so for the life we have in you, Christ Jesus. We thank you for another opportunity to come into your presence, to praise you, to glorify you, to give thanks unto you and to celebrate you. For the many miracles we have received, we give you thanks. For salvation rich and free, we give you thanks. For your provision, we give you thanks. For your mercies, we give you thanks. For your grace which you have bestowed upon us, we give you thanks. For your steadfast love which endures from generation to generation, we give you thanks. For your faithfulness to us, Even when we have been unfaithful, we give you thanks. So as we come before you today, we pray that you would forgive us again, wherever we have wronged, for not being obedient to you. Forgive us, O Lord. For our disbelief, forgive us, O Lord. For our lack of faith, O Lord, forgive us. For believing in anything and anyone beside you, O God, forgive us. We pray that as you forgive us today, your Spirit will guide us into your truth, so that we may turn from our unrighteousness and be clothed in your righteousness. Today, Almighty God, we lift up before you the leaders of our nations, and especially those leaders in our South Caribbean islands. May you continue to empower them with godly wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to lead our people aright. Grant unto them men and women who would be able to provide them with counsel that comes from on high. We pray that you would give direction to them, especially in the areas of economic development. And we continue to give you the praise that you have always been our source, our Jehovah Jireh, in whom all abundance resides. May they and we trust you for your continued direction, especially in this area. We continue to lift up all families, especially those who would have lost a loved one during this season. We remember especially the family of our dear Reverend Glenham Spencer. Her family and the extended church family, especially those in Guyana and Antigua. We give you thanks for her life and her witness of you, Christ Jesus. We pray for our connectional bishop, Reverend Galbraith. Give him the strength to continue in your service. And may he continue to be supported by the ministers and people of this region. We also pray for district bishop, that you would also be with him. Give him strength to give the leadership and direction that the church needs, especially during this new season that we are in. May our hearts be open as your servants to receive the newness of your Spirit and to be prepared for the revival that you would cause us to experience. Touch the hearts of all those who are listening to this program by the power of your Holy Spirit. And we open up ourselves for healing and deliverance where our hearts are broken, where our spirits are in bondage, and where our bodies may be diseased. Minister to us through the songs we would sing, to the reading and listening of your Holy Scripture, and to the meditation our hearts would embrace, and for the sweet fellowship we would experience. We offer these prayers in the name alone that is wonderful and worthy of all praise, adoration, and glory, the name of Jesus Christ. And we say amen and amen.
City, city's in heaven. from Psalm 61, verses 1 and 2. Hear my cry, O God. Listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth I call to you. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Let us pray. Bless your word unto our hearts and glorify your name. Speak now, O God, as only you alone can, and may our hearts be blessed. And may we be challenged through the power of your Spirit. Amen. David, the man after God's own heart, was also a man of prayer. Psalm 61 is one of David's morning prayers. Often David would get up early and meet God before he started his day. Psalm 5 and verse 3 tells us how David prayed in the early morning hours. My voice shalt thou hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee and will look up. David directed his prayer toward God in the wee hours of the morning. Often he would pour his heart out and cry unto the Lord. Such was the case in Psalm 61. We are not told of the specific circumstances out of which this psalm has emerged. However, many interpreters believe that it was probably written while David was on the run from his son Absalom. When David's son Absalom rebelled against him and the kingdom, David took refuge on Mount Zion. There, David set up a tent. We see in verse 4, I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. We understand this because the word David used here for tabernacle is different from the word used to describe the main tabernacle. Here it is simply a tent. David had set up his tent as a place of worship and refuge on Mount Zion while his son was waging war against him. It was in this special place of worship David met God regularly. In Psalm 61, we see the very heart of David during one of the darkest and most difficult moments in his life. And verses 1 and 2 shows us that David was very transparent before God. Hear my cry, O God, listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth I call to you, I cry to you. And when my heart is faint, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. The phrase from the end of the earth means that David felt banished from the spot which was the center of his delight. And at the same time, his mind was in a depressed condition. That David's absence from his homeland compounds his feeling of discouragement and exhaustion. The phrase also hints at feeling of estrangement from God himself. To be absent from the place of divine worship was a source of deep, deep sorrow to saints in the Old Testament times. They looked upon the tabernacle as the center of the world, and they counted themselves to be at the far end of the universe when they could no longer resort to the sacred shrine. Their heart was heavy as in a strange land where they were banished from its solemnities. Yet even they knew right well
that no place is unsuitable for prayer. There may be an end of the earth, but there must not be an end of devotion, of worship, of praise, of trusting in a God who's beyond space or time. When my heart is overwhelmed, it's to speak of a state of depression, to be covered with grief and sorrow for any trouble, outward or inward, and ready to sink and fail and die. To be overwhelmed is to overspread or crush beneath something violent and weighty that covers or encompasses the whole, as to be overwhelmed with waves. To be overwhelmed is to be immersed and bear down. In other words, David was saying that he was at a place where he felt powerless. He was at a place where he had exhausted his own energies and resources and strength and power. Lord, I have done everything within my powers and I have failed. Therefore, this is beyond me. I have exhausted my resources. I am spent. I am weary. I am tired. I am anxious and I'm afraid. My brothers and sisters, I would imagine that perhaps for many of us, there have been times in our lives where we have really felt as if we were in a dry, dusty, weary place. And when we look at our circumstances, so all we can really do, like David, is to cry out unto the Lord. Hear my cry, O Lord, attend unto my prayer. And sometimes we cry out, where are you, God? Because it seems as though we are alone. It seems as though we are weighed down by situations. It seems as though there is no way out. And we cry out, my God, where are you? God, where are you? My family's falling apart. God, where are you? I have lost my job and I don't know how to make ends meet. God, where are you? My child is dying of cancer. God, where are you? My marriage is in shambles. God, where are you? I'm just so lonely and alone. God, where are you? I'm stuck in habitual sin. God, where are you? I'm in the midst of suicidal thoughts. God, where are you? I'm in a state of depression and confusion. God, where are you? Some of you are asking these questions right now, and in the midst of deep, deep suffering and pain and hardship and confusion. My brothers and sisters, these are honest questions. And I believe that the Word of God speaks to them even now. Hear my cry, O God, attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee when my heart is overwhelmed. Lead me, Lord, to the rock that is higher than I. It seems to David the end of the world. When I get to the end of the proverbial world, when I have no place else to turn, where do I turn? What do I do? Every one of us are driven by circumstances sooner or later in our lives to this end of the road type of an experience where I have no place else to go, no place else to turn. And where I turn at this point is so important. Some people turn to drugs. Some people turn to alcohol. Some people turn to violence. Some people turn to end it all, to suicide. Some people turn to pornography. Some people turn to other things that are destructive. David, however, turned to the Lord, and he cries out, "Hear my cry, O God, attend to my prayer. When I've come to the end of the earth, lead me to the rock that is higher than I." My brothers and sisters, there is a place of refuge. There's a place of strength. There's a place of security that we can have in Christ Jesus, the rock that is higher than I. The place where I can be sheltered from the storms of life, sheltered from the enemy, protected. A rock is a symbol of strength in the Bible. The Bible says concerning Jehovah, he is our rock and our fortress. So when my heart is overwhelmed, when I've come to the end of the rope, when I've come to the end of my world, when I've come to the end of life as I have known it, lead me, Lord, to the rock that is higher than I. My soul in its conflicts and sorrows would fly, so sinful, so weary. Thine would I be, thou blessed rock of ages. I'm hiding in thee, thou blessed rock of ages. I'm hiding in thee. It is so comforting to know that when I've reached the edge, the end of the road, the end of the rope, I can turn to God who makes a way where there is no way. There is a verse of the song, "He Giveth More Grace," that beautifully describes it. He giveth more grace as our burdens grow greater. He sendeth more strength as our labors increase. To added afflictions, he added his mercy. To multiplied trials, he multiplies peace. When we have exhausted our store of endurance, when our strength has failed ere the day is half done, when we reach the end of our hoarded resources, our Father's full giving is only begun. His love has no limits. His grace has no measure. His power no boundary known unto men. For out of his infinite riches in Jesus, he giveth, and he giveth, and he giveth more grace. And when I've come to the end, when I'm overwhelmed, and I cry unto him, that rock that is higher than I, when I come to the end of the road, God has just begun his glorious work in my life. The psalm contains an amazing little Hebrew phrase that is not apparent at first look. In verse 2, David says, "Lead me to the rock that is higher than I." In this phrase, David looks ahead confidently to God, believing that he's a rock of refuge that will prove to be larger than his problem with his son. Literally, it means, lead me to the rock that will prove itself higher than I. My brothers and sisters, maybe like David, there are some of you who have come to the end of your world, the end of the rope. Maybe like David, there are some of us who can cry out, "Hear my cry, O Lord, attend to my prayer from the end of the earth, because we're at a place of deep, deep sorrow, depression, pain. Life has done its worst. Maybe you're at a place where you feel like giving up. But here again, David is not ready to throw in the towel. David is not ready to give up on life yet. David knows that there has to be something more than what he is experiencing and feeling. And he knows that that something better is in God. And so he calls upon God and he says, God, I don't know how to find it in and of myself. I don't know where to go to find it. But God, I know that it has to be in you and through you. And so, Lord, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Lead me, Lord. Take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me on. Lead me on. Wherever you lead me, God, I will follow, because in and of myself, I have come to the end of the road. But God, with you, there has to be something better. So lead me to the rock that is higher than I. The sadness described in this psalm is not an everyday sadness. The level of exhaustion and resignation is not the normal tiredness we feel at the end of the day. It is a profound, soul-rending sense of loss and fear. It is important, my brothers and sisters, not to make light of the deep struggles others may go through by comparing your pain, however legitimate, with theirs. Don't make light of people's situations and circumstances, but recognize that we serve a God who meets us at our points of need. And maybe you are in that far place. Maybe you feel as though you are at the end of the road, the end of the world. Maybe you feel overwhelmed by life, especially within the last several months. Maybe you feel lost, afraid of the future, like David. Stretch out your hand to God and allow God to lead you into the future, to lead you into the place of abundant life, to lead you into the place of quiet rest, to lead you to the rock that is higher than you are. And so, gracious God, we bless you for who you are in Christ Jesus. Thank you for watching over us as a shepherd watches over his flock. Thank you for getting involved in our lives, sharing our pain, ministering to us at our points of and places of hurt. Thank you, God, for being interested in us, in our well-being. And even now, God, I pray for that man, that woman, that young person, that child who feel lost, forgotten, neglected, that person who is struggling with life, who's carrying deep, deep sorrow, pain. I pray, oh God, for that person who have had suicidal thoughts, that person who feels unloved, betrayed. I pray, God, that they may sense your presence now and may know your healing power. Reach out to them as only you alone can and give them peace. Not the peace the world offers, but the peace that comes only from you. The peace that passes all understanding, that will keep their heart and mind in the knowledge and the love of you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
safe to the rock that is higher than I. My soul in its conflicts and sorrows would fly. So sinful, so weary, thine would I be. Thou blessed rock of ages, I'm hiding in thee. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may abound in hope. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of his Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to his word and may it dwell in all of us richly.